So next up on the weird kit review, we've got the MPM DC2 rebuilt bomber in 1/72 scale. This is the Douglas Dakota, but the DC2 version. So the one that you see used in the D-Day landings and all over the world for a huge amount of time, even to this current day, is the DC3. Slightly different, not a huge amount of variation between the DC2 and the DC3, and this is pretty much the only kit in this scale which is any sense. And let's have a look inside. So getting into the box, this is pretty much short run technology here. So with that, there's obviously a few things you've got to take for granted, much like Special Hobby, CMK, they're all more or less under the same brand. Here you've got a nice parts layout, so we do have some resin here and a bit of etch metal, as well as injection moulding kit as well. There are three versions of this, I believe. You've got this one, and then the other two are two different marking options. And then starting off, just running through, we're just going to basically run through here. You've obviously got a nice cockpit there, a little bit basic on the internal side of things, but these are both converted bombers, so there wouldn't be a ton of stuff inside. Few bits you've got to cut out here if you're doing camouflage A, which is the finished one. And as you can see, you're very quickly getting the fuselage halves together and getting the wing on, which is in three sections. Again, not always a fan of this. I prefer to have that as one piece, but you know, hopefully it will go together. Checking the dihedral here of the wing. And then simple undercarriage going on, and then you've got some bomb racks here, again just for version A, the finished version, and then you've got different tail fins and rudders here, as well as a few optional parts here as well going on the front. Two different nose types, you've got camouflage A and B, use this, camouflage C, use that. Engines going on, a few final touches, and then we're into choosing the markings. So you've got two finish options here, both with included a finish swastika, which is the blue swastika, and that is in two halves, being the Eastern European company. That's how they send these out. And you've got a camouflage version and a light blue-grey version. And then going over, we've got a Spanish Civil War nationalist version here, which is the one flown by Captain Vara de Rey, which is written here as the Spanish Rebellious Air Forces in autumn 1936. It's the nationalists. Everything's loose. But again, it's what you come to expect with this. You do get a few knot parts, but luckily we've got the canopy parts are separate and there's only a small piece. As you can see there, my bit has been knocked off. We won't get into the bag here. It's just really basic stuff. It's only an angled windscreen there with one frame in the middle on each side, and then you've got side windows here. There's also a vac form piece here for one of the versions. Then we've got decals, bit of photo etch, and a bag of resin. So looking at the decals, which are quite colourful, as you can see, you've got the nationalist versions there, which has the quite well-known nationalist insignia there with the black circle with the white cross with the white crossing over it, a large round black circle for ground identification, which is a big decal. I'm sure it'll be okay, but that goes on the center section of the underside of the wing. Then we've got numbering here to go along the side, and the again more identification insignia to go on the underside over a white background, I believe. So that's nice to have that as decals. And then we've got the finished decals here. Here you can see the swastikas in two halves, and they go on their white backing. And the small photo etch fret here just covers a few bits for the outside of the aircraft, as well as, I believe, that's fins for the bombs. Then the bag of resin, I'm not going to get this out again for the same reason that you can lose parts quite easily, but there's a whole load of delicate stuff in there, some of which is used on the interior and the cockpit. We've also got the separate nose there for one of the marking options and a few other small parts. All cast very nicely. I have been in there before and had a look. I can't see any casting problems or anything like that. And again, like I said, it is out of the same company as Special Hobby, CMK and all the rest of it. So it's... you can guarantee quality of the same standard. So looking at the first sprue there, you've got the two fuselage halves covered in the iconic panel lining that these aircraft are well known for, and it shows up, and that's all recessed, which is good to know. On the inside it's blind, so obviously it's only been moulded on one side, so there's no interior detail there. Again, blind here with blind moulding here with the halves of the horizontal stabilisers here. And you've also got the undercarriage there, the wheels, which they look fine. They do the job as far as this is concerned. Then the next sprue covers the two engines, and they're just fronts here that go into the cowlings. Few small parts for the interior. This is the inside walkway there for the interior as well. And we get the upper halves. Oh no, the lower halves of the wings there, I believe. No, I think they are the upper halves of the wing. And the two different tail fins there. And then finally we've got the other halves of the wings, and this is the individual centre section here as well, which, like I said, hopefully that join is a nice tight join and doesn't give any issues. Separate propeller blades here, as well as parts for the undercarriage all the way running around here, and there's the instrument panel, as well as a few small parts here. And overall, very, very cleanly moulded. As you can see, there's no flash there whatsoever, not even a hint of it, and there's barely any parting lines either. Running around the parts, and the panel line there. Panel lines are extremely crisp, as you may be able to see there. I mean, all in all, very good. So that is the DC2 by MPM. A little bit expensive, based on the fact it's short run. This can be ranging around the sort of £50 mark. I got this on a deal on Hannon's. I'm not sure if it's still running. It was a month or so ago. I think it was just around the £30 mark. I think it might have been under, about 28. So I thought I'd jump on it as far as that's concerned, obviously, looking at that marking option. There is the other version, which I prefer. That has the Republican version, which is just a nicer camouflage, and I try not to be too heavy on the old nationalists as far as the Spanish Civil War stuff's concerned. You've also got the Finnish version as well, which is a nice inclusion if you're looking to do that. You're not like me, fascinated by the aircraft of the Spanish Civil War. So yeah, I mean, mixed feelings. If you were to get it full retail, I think it's between 40, 45, possibly 50 in places. A little bit expensive for what you get, but I mean, you've got to weigh that up when it comes to building aircraft like this. You know, there's not many DC2s in 172nd. So hopefully that gives you an idea what's in the box, and if you see it around, pick it up. And if you like what you've seen in this review, please give the video a like, subscribe to the channel if not already, and I'll see you in the next video.